bread of life, sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. But you are the living word, faith now. Come on.
A day of marvels and miracles. A day to rejoice in what God Pastor, yesterday was filled with many words and too little faith.
On this Easter morning, we hear the Lord saying, "Mary, don't you weep."
This is a new day, a day of marvels and miracles, a day to rejoice in what the Lord has done. Yesterday was filled with too much criticism and too little affirmation.
Today, Mother, don't you moan.
This is a new day, a day of marvels, a day to rejoice in what God has done. Yesterday was filled with too many questions and too few answers.
This is Easter morning. God has conquered death, and Jesus has canceled sin. This is the beginning of a new day.
Our scripture reading will be coming from the 118th division of Psalms, 1 to the second verse, and followed by the 14th through the 24th verse. When you have it, say amen. Need a little bit more time, say wait. I hear you waiting. All right. The 118th division of Psalms. And it reads, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever." Let Israel now say that his mercy endureth forever. Verse 14, "The Lord is my strength and song, and he is become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacle of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord hath chastened me sore, but he hath not given me over unto death. Open to me the gates of righteousness. I will go into him and give, and I will praise the Lord. The gates of the Lord unto which the righteous shall enter. I will praise thee, for thou hast heard me, and art become my salvation. The stone which the builder refused is become the headstone of the corner. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day which the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it." The next scripture we're reading will be coming from the epistles. 1 Corinthians 15, chapter 15, the 1st through the 11th verse. "Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I prepared unto you, which also ye have received, and wherein ye stand, by which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures, and that he was seen of Cephas, then of the 12. After that, he was seen of above 500 brothers at once, of whom the greater part remain unto this present, but some are fallen asleep. After that, he was seen of James, then all the apostles, and last of all, he was seen of me also, as of one born out of due time. For I am the least of the apostles, that I am not meet to be called the apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace, which was bestowed upon me, was not in vain, but I labor more abundantly than they are. Yet not I, but the grace of God which was within me. Therefore, whether it were I or they, so we preach, and so ye believe." The gospel.
Our gospel reading is coming from John, the 20th chapter, verses 1 through 18. And I'll be reading from the Message translation. "Early in the morning, on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone was moved away from the entrance. She ran at once to Simon Peter and to the other disciple, the other one Jesus loved, breathlessly panting. They took the master from the tomb. We don't know where they had put him. Peter and the other disciple left immediately for the tomb. They ran neck and neck. The other disciple going to the tomb first, outrunning Peter. Stupid to look in, he saw the pieces of linen cloth lying there, but he didn't go in. Simon Peter arrived after him, entered the tomb, observed the linen cloth lying there, and the kerchief used to cover his head, not lying with the linens, but separate, neatly folded by itself. Then the other disciple, the one who had gotten there first, went into the tomb, took one look at the evidence, and believed. No one yet knew from the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The disciples then went back home. But Mary stood outside the tomb weeping. As she wept, she knelt to look into the tomb and saw two angels sitting there, dressed in white, one at the head and the other at the foot of where Jesus' body had been laid. They said to her, "Woman, why do you weep?" "They took my master," she said, "and I don't know where they put him." After she said this, she turned away and saw Jesus standing there, but she didn't recognize him. Jesus spoke to her, "Woman, why do you weep? Who are you looking for?" She, thinking he was the gardener, said, "Mister, if you took him, tell me where you put him so I can care for him." Jesus said, "Mary." Turning to face him, she said in Hebrew, "Rabboni," meaning teacher. Jesus said, "Don't cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go to my brothers and tell them, I ascend to my Father and your Father, my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went telling the news of the disciples, "I saw the Master," and she told him everything he said to her. The word of God for the people of God, from all that dwell below the skies. And God spake all these words, saying, "I am the Lord thy God, who brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt have no other gods before me." Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image, or any likeness of anything that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation of them that hate me, and showing mercy unto thousands of them that love me and keep my commandments. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain, for the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God. In it thou shalt not do any work, thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter, thy manservant, nor thy stranger that is within thy gates. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Wherefore the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it. Commit adultery, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thy neighbor's.